So there's a town about an hour west of here called Normal, Illinois. Mm-hmm. And one of my best friends, until recently, lived halfway between my town, Urbana, and Normal. So every time, you know, if something crazy happened in her life or when we would, you know, drive out there to spend the evening with them, I was always like, you know, well, you're so halfway to Normal. You're just like the most diverse, crazy, I mean, really outrageous collection of friends here in this town. I never would have imagined that I would meet so many people with so many wonderful, bizarre stories. And so I started thinking, you know, we have all these ideas about Normal.
Right.
Growing up, like, this is what a normal life looks like. This is what a normal career, a normal marriage, a normal family. And you think to realize that it's just, you know, I mean, first of all, there's no such thing. And second of all, this may be halfway to normal place, this place that you find yourself in, like you're working toward normal, but you're right. Kind of like, you end up here. But that's actually the place where the good things happen, the good life is.
Look, I noticed this theme or pattern, and maybe you do too, that surprise is an element. It's almost like there's a lot of surprises in your life that you take note of them and you put them on your blog. And even in this story, it's like there's a surprise ending, you know. And so could you speak to that? Spiritually speaking, what have been some surprises?
When your life is sort of like turned upside down in different ways that you never anticipated. When I was a teenager, if somebody had told me this would be my life, you know, this like, you know, that I would be married to someone who is not the father of my daughters, and I would be a stepmom, and I, you know, all of these things, I would have been like, are you crazy? You know, I mean, that's not what I envisioned, but there's something, I guess I feel like God works in really powerful ways when we're caught by surprise. And in my life in particular, I feel that I had to be sort of shook up in my expectations and my idea of what normal was in order to really see God and really understand who I am and what my role in God's plan is in this world. And you know, I kind of feel like I couldn't have gotten here without all that upheaval and surprise. That was like sort of key. And so I'm constantly looking for more surprise and trying to just be expectant about what it might lead to. So, unlike Jen Lutweiler, I claim my dog.
He's not mine. I don't claim him. He's not mine.
She clearly likes my dog, even though she pretends she doesn't like any dogs. When she comes to the house, she'll like be all, you know, petting and...
We are not friends.
She really likes my dog, even though she pretends she
are not friends. We never have
friends.
The waiting and the working. Like, we're waiting for Jesus, but we're also working toward bringing his kingdom to earth while we wait. And so it's not an either or, it's a both and. But I started thinking about that in all sorts of really personal ways in addition to that way. And one of the ways I thought about it was, you know, I don't have to just write about Advent. I'm a blogger, of course I feel the need to put everything into words, but what if I just started looking? And what if I started thinking visually about frames, things around me that speak to Advent? And it felt extremely like freeing. Well, it's basically a memoir about the very things we've just been talking about a life that hasn't turned out at all like I expected, and how God works with us and meets us in these unexpected places and, you know, does something really more powerful than we could ever anticipate. So it's a book about divorce and spirituality, my relationship with God and depression. Mm-hmm. And a lot of those things wrapped up together in something that I think is really far more universal.